What is the first thing you would do if you were weightless?
What if I said this whole concept doesn't even exist? Let me explain.
We have all seen footage of astronauts floating freely in space. As a result, many people believe there's zero gravity there. Yet, this statement cannot be further from the truth. Gravity does exist everywhere in the universe, because it is defined as a force that attracts two bodies to each other. This means that gravity never reaches zero, but it can get pretty close. In our system, objects with relatively little mass will have less of the sun's gravitational force than celestial bodies like Jupiter, especially if this body is far from it, just like in Einstein's relativity theory. The International Space Station, for example, has its forward motion equal to the speed of its fall toward the planet, but at the same time, they're not getting any closer to it. This means the astronauts inside are not pulled in any particular direction, so they float in a constant freefall. But you don't have to leave Earth to escape the bounds of gravity. Anyone who crashed at the top of the hill on a fast roller coaster or sat in a plane that was pushed down suddenly shortly experienced weightlessness. But you can also feel a remotely similar feeling by swimming, but it's just not the same thing. If you really want to experience weightlessness and have $1,000 extra with you, you may want to try the vomit comet. These parabolic flights have been preparing astronauts for what microgravity will feel like. And now, anyone can have a taste of the astronaut's life, even though it's for only 25 seconds. It's still pretty sick. There, you can feel the Martian gravity, the lunar gravity, and the zero-g force without any harmful effects in the long term. Maybe just some nausea, you know. I was gonna tell another gravity joke, but I guess we'll have to wait till next time. Don't forget to check the links below to learn more about this topic. And stay awesome!